This is the low power histology of NLD or Necrobiosis Lipoidica Diabeticorum. Classically, NLD presents with atrophic yellow patches, usually on the shins, although in around 15% of cases, areas affected can include the hands, fingers, forearms, scalp, and face. NLD is associated with diabetes, but only one in around 300 diabetics will develop Necrobiosis Lipoidica Diabeticorum. Having said that, most patients with NLD have or will develop diabetes. The condition is three times more frequent in females than males and can occur at any age. The gross appearance is that of lesions that are well demarcated, irregular patches or plaques with yellowish centres and a violaceous periphery, and the lesions tend to be depressed. Histologically, the overlying epidermis is either normal or atrophic. As the name implies, there is necrobiosis with disintegrating dermal collagen. This is surrounded by a lymphohistiocytic inflammatory infiltrate that may be palisaded and contain some giant cells, and the infiltrate may extend into the underlying fat in the subcutaneous tissue. And another feature is the presence of thickened blood vessels, and it is thought likely that it is the vascular damage that causes the necrobiosis to occur. On low power, the features of NLD can be appreciated. The central part of the lesion shows rather featureless deep pink staining or eosinophilic collagen, and at the periphery is the inflammatory infiltrate. In this biopsy of NLD, the overlying epidermis is normal. And here is a higher power view of the inflammatory infiltrate that is composed largely of lymphocytes and histiocytes with a sprinkling of giant cells. And finally, the inflammatory infiltrate can be seen extending into the subcutaneous fat.